Good evening, YouTube. Well, end of my last video, I said that after another half hour or so of monkeying with this, that I got it to within a half of a thousandth of an inch, and that's probably as good as we're going to get. So now, of course, that doesn't want to come off. What did I do with... So now, I have been looking at this Hardinge L18 quick change tool post online, and I found three or four places that they're selling them, and it has a T-bolt with... One of them has a collar nut. One of them has a T handle. One of them has an extended nut with it, and they all claim to be factory complete. So I went. I found the patent for this online, and yes, only one attachment point here is necessary. According to the patent, only one is recommended. So, when I made this block here, I drilled and tapped it to be able to mount the chuck like, or the tool post like this, or like this. But now, I think what I want to do is mount it like this. So now, the only spare wrench I have that is period-esque is this one, which is Grey Tools Canada. .11/16 and .10/32.
Oh, what?
I need the vernier calipers off the other workbench there. So anyway, I got editing the video we shot the other day, and I realized I did not film a conclusion to Hardinge L18 quick change tool post.
I'm thinking no.
Yes.
Habidabida.
Okay, that I don't like. Mind you, I didn't check this to see if that was tight at all. I'm not used to that thing moving at all, because I'm used to it being attached with two bolts. Semaphore? YMCA?
Just a dancing fool.
I don't know why that now hits. It didn't before.
Is that supposed to be in the back there?
What?
The wrench?
Yes, that's okay. What I just said. I don't know why that hits now. It doesn't. It doesn't before. There, we have it straight across now.
Getting there. Okay.
See, remember there was that much gap almost, like that?
Okay.
I guess maybe one more finishing pass on that, and back of this. Almost. There we go. That will fit. Inside that. Now I also have the ability the Aurigel just is not working anymore. On my belt grinder upgrade video, I commented to looking behind, who is building up a very similar lathe. He ordered an AXA quick change tool holder for theirs. And I was saying that I kind of regret having gone the route of this one, the Hardinge L18, except that I got the Hardinge L18, an actual official Hardinge L20 tool holder, and about 20 shop-made tool holders for $50. I had never seen one of these set up on a lathe, and I wrongfully assumed that, well, it's got two holes, it's got to be screwed down in two places. But after having read the patent on the thing, the patent talks about using this one to secure when you're using tools on this side and using this one to secure it when you're using tools on this side. And now you still have the ability to turn this the way you do. I've run out. Oh well. This tool isn't going to do what I wanted it to, but I need to get in tight there and come out and square that up. But this has all the same range of motion as the AXA tool holders, so I no longer regret having gone this route. That I didn't torque down on that, and it stayed beautiful going across that, so I am more than happy. So there, that is the completion. That is the completion of the Hardinge L18 quick change tool post update. Now it is working beautifully for me. That's it for now, and thanks for watching. With my love and leave this life behind.